What's up, guys? T-Croc here. Welcome to the vlog. As I mentioned in the previous video, I was going to talk about tuning because one of my very good friends and the first guy to ever tune my 3G, Cody, is going back to tuning. If you guys didn't know, he was on the forums. I think he was TX Codeman, and he had the TX Tuning website. Cody had a 3G, which he tuned as a 3.0, and then he swapped a 3.8 into it and tuned it, and he actually supercharged it and tuned it as well. And he also swapped a Myvec and tuned that car as well. He's also tuned plenty of people on the forum. If you actually just go to the forum and look up his reviews, every review is great. He might have like a few bad reviews, but usually those tuning reviews were because the car was wrong. So, a little background history on Cody. He stopped tuning because basically it wasn't profitable and the 3G just started to decline. But he's actually working on a 3G. I'm not going to give it away, but he's actually working on a car that's 3G related. So he thought about going back into tuning. So I told him I would do a video to let everybody know that, hey, here's an option for you guys to do tuning. If you guys are looking for a tune, it is super beneficial, even if you are stock. The OEM tune on the car is super rich, and the timing is very, very conservative. And the only reason why is because it has a big safety net, so you don't blow up your car. Now, I'm not going to say when you get this tune, you're going to blow up your car or anything like that, because Cody will actually look at logs and make sure the tune is safe and it's not knocking and it's not running too lean or too rich. So you don't have to worry about that. And Cody has so much experience. So this is one of those beneficial things where you can gain, let's say, I would say even if on a stock OEM Eclipse, you can gain the 10 to 15 horsepower just from tuning it, because that's how super rich the car is. Now, if you have mods, then you can just think about the endless gains that you can actually get, but you can actually make more power than what you are doing right now. So with ECU flash, you actually are going into the ECU and editing the fuel tables and the timing tables. I've talked about it in previous videos. I kind of have the overview and gist of how tuning works. I just personally don't want to tune people's cars. But Cody is more than welcome to do it. He's only for the moment tuning 3.0, 3.5, 3.8. All in it. He's not going to do boosted cars right now. So if you guys are boosted, I would just send him a message on the forum. He may do it. He may not. But I do know he said that he just wanted to do NA cars for now, because when you get into the boosted realm, it gets very complicated. So the purpose of this video is to basically tell you what everything you need before you actually go to Cody for this tune. So first thing in order is make sure your car is in good order. No check engine lights. Actually, let me go back on that. You can have check engine lights. For example, I have a check engine light because I don't have an EGR or EVAP. That's not going to affect the drivability of the car. But if you have a misfire or an O2 sensor, a primary O2 sensor, the secondary O2 sensors, those don't matter. A primary or something, like if your car is just not up to par, do not go and get a tune, because you're going to either A, you're going to blow your motor, or B, the car is going to run worse. So fix anything on the car before you contact Cody. Second thing on the list is you're going to need a laptop. And I would say you don't have to go and buy the most expensive laptop. I think I spent like $50 on mine. And the only reason why is because you're going to need two programs that I'm going to talk about later in the video. And you're going to need a cable for data login and to rewrite for the ECU. So just get a decent laptop, maybe one with Wi-Fi on it, or some way that you can have internet access. That way, if Cody needs to talk to you, you can talk through him through the internet. Third thing you're gonna need is a cable. Now, there's a 1.3 cable, and I think like 1.3U, 1.3R. Most of them are the same. I think R is for reflashable, so I would probably get that. They also have the 2.0 cable. You don't really need the 2.0 cable. The 1.3 is actually a little bit better because it's faster at data logging. The 2.0 cable came out for the Evo X's because the OBD system is different on there, so they use that one. There's also a couple other differences. I think that one you can actually data log without a laptop, so if you want to go that route, I think you actually put a card in or something like that. I personally have not used the 2.0 cable. I will let you know that you're going to have to go to buy one. You're either going to have to buy one used, so you can actually go to an Evo website or Evo M. That's the Evo forum. They post them left and right. You can get them used. Just be careful with buying used ones because sometimes when they're used, they don't work that great. Or if you're like me, I personally want to buy a brand new cable. So I actually go to the source and go to evoscan.com. The reason why I go to evoscan.com is because you can actually get everything on that site, and they actually go through the details of what's the difference between all the cables. Sorry, that noise you hear is my dog playing right now, so I don't want her to take her toys away. But anyway, so go to evoscan.com. You can download the data logging program, which I think is like $14 to $15. It might be, that's how much I paid. It might be a little bit more. It might be like $20 now. The cable itself, can be between, if you don't buy used, because I know used cables go for like $50. Brand new ones are almost $150. Just let you know that these cables are coming from out of the country, from like the UK. So it does take time for these cables to arrive. So if you do not have the time to wait, then you can probably take your chance buying one used. The next thing you're going to need is, depending on your mods. Now, if you just have like an intake and exhaust, you don't need a wideband. But let's say you have headers and all that, I would definitely recommend a wideband. The way Kodi tunes, and because for data logging and stuff, you're going to need a wideband. That way he can actually tune your car spot on, and your air fuel ratios are not going to be, you know, super lean or super rich. And you can also just keep an eye on them, and you can actually see the difference when you add mods to see if it made your car lean or rich, and see if you need to retune. So I would personally recommend, there's a couple of wideband you can go with. I just stick with a couple brands. Z-tronics, that's what I have. They actually have an LCD screen, or you can get, I know they made a new, I think it's a ZT3, which is like a gauge style type if you're not into the LCD screen. AEM is another good brand that you can use. I actually personally did use that one first, and then I switched over to Z-tronics. Another good brand is Innovate. Innovate has a very good wideband, and all of these are actually, they actually are good with EvoScan. So EvoScan has a option so you can data log your wideband as well. And they already integrated these widebands. So all you do is you click wideband and you choose which one you are. And it already knows which one it is. So it'll download it while you're data logging. The next thing you're going to have to get is you're going to have to download the ECU Flash program, which is totally free. Just go to traxic.com and download the latest one. I think the latest update is the 1.42. So you just download that, and then you have your data logging program, which is EvoScan. You have your reflashing program, which is ECU Flash. So once you have all those things, you head on over to club3g.com, and there's a thread that Kodi has basically reposted. So you guys can go to him and then just message him or post in that thread, and then he will send you instructions on how to data log and how to flash and all that. He actually has written steps so you're not left in the dark, and he'll email them to you, and you'll just basically know how to set everything up. And you're basically going to be doing some pulls, third gear pulls, fourth gear pulls, depending on what he needs. And then you're going to send him those data logs, and then he's going to look them over, and he's going to retune the car and send you a different file, and you're going to flash it to your car, and then that's how you get tuned. So that's it, guys. I just wanted to let you guys know that this option is available now. is something I highly recommend. Anybody who has a lot of mods to their car and it's NA and they want to gain some more power. Now, if you already have been tuned, then you don't have to worry about this. But if your car, if you basically have intake exhaust headers and you're running on stock tune, I'm telling you, you're doing yourself a disservice and you probably will need a tune to gain more power to reap the benefits of all these mods. So that's it, guys. I will see you guys next week. Like and subscribe.